Mother, a word that gives us many beautiful feelings, care, sympathy, and unconditional love. Mother is the first thing we say, and the first person that we love, that we feel safe of being around her. But could this kind of love, the mother's love, lead to an unfortunate dark end, to be harmful? Today's story is about Elizabeth Duncan, one of the worst mothers through history. So what did she do to gain that title? The worst mother-in-law. When Elizabeth gave birth to her son, she claimed that there was an instant connection between them. You would say that every mother has the same connection to her son, and that's normal. In Elizabeth's case, it was not a normal mother and son love. It was an obsession. She did not let anything stand between her and her son, not even his wife. She was described as a drifter, said to have married at least 11 times. She had one child, Frank, and she also had a daughter, Patricia, who died at the age of 15. Her son Frank was her obsession, the center of her life. Frank was a handsome young man who was working as a lawyer. In November 1957, Elizabeth moved in to live with her favorite child, Frank, who lived in Santa Barbara. His friends advised him to live alone and to get away from his mom's obsession. When he told her that, she freaked out. It was her biggest nightmare to be separated from her son. When he saw her reaction and that she refused to cooperate, he ordered her to move out. Instead, she took an overdose of sleeping pills that led her to the hospital. And there her nightmare became true, or even worse than she thought it would be. Her nurse was a young girl, Olga Kopczek, who started to get to know her son Frank through his visits to the hospital. The connection was clear between the two, and that's why she tried many times to separate them, but she couldn't. They fell in love and wanted to get married, and that's what made her go crazy even more. Elizabeth told Olga that she won't be able to marry her son, and threatened her not to move on this relationship. Otherwise, she would murder her. But she didn't listen. And in July 1958, Frank and Olga got married in secret. One night when Frank was with Olga, his mom knocked the door. She started fighting with her son and forced him to come back and live with her. He changed his residency over and over again. And every time his mother discovered where he's living. And continuously coming trying to ruin their life. Until she realized that the only way to separate them is to get rid of Olga. When Olga told Frank about his mother's threats, he refused to believe it. His mother told him it wasn't true. When the harassments and threats didn't work, Elizabeth began to offer money to her friends to help her kill Olga. Among them is a waitress. She offered her $1,500 to throw acid in Olga's face and then push her off a cliff. The waitress told Frank instead. But when he again confronted his mother, she again denied it. Through a friend, Elizabeth found two men, Luis Moya and Agostini Baldonado. And they said they will do the job for $3,000. On November 1958, Moya and Baldonado borrowed a car and a gun and lured Olga from her apartment. They told her that her husband was drunk in the back seat of their car. They shoved her inside the car and she fought back, kicking and scratching. They beat her again, choked her and dumped her body in a shallow grave. No one knows whether she was dead or alive when they buried her. Weeks later, both men were arrested on unrelated charges. Elizabeth was afraid that they would spill their secret. She told her son that they had been blackmailing her. Frank reported that to the police. That didn't work. Police became more suspicious about Olga's disappearance and pressed the men, who confessed and told them about the $3,000 deal. They said that if they had known Olga was pregnant, they would not have killed her. Sorry, I didn't mention that. Olga was pregnant. Despite the 44 witnesses, including the hitman, Elizabeth denied any knowledge of the crime. 4 weeks after the trial began, She was convicted on first-degree murder and sentenced to be executed. Moya and Baldenado tried to flee by sawing through their cell bars with smuggled hacksaw blades, but they failed. After 3 years, in 1962, Elizabeth walked into the gas chamber to be executed. Her last words were, "Where is Frank? I'm innocent." But Frankie wasn't there. And this is our story for today. There will be more stories coming, so be sure to follow me and subscribe. And until next time.